Hello children, how are you all children? I hope you have seen the previous slide or video that I have sent on chapter number 16, food crop agriculture part 2. And last time children, I have already told you that this chapter will be taken under the heading major crops of India. First part I have already done, and previous chapter that we have done was agriculture part 1. In agriculture part 2, we are taking food crops. Then in the next class, next time when we will complete this chapter, then we will take cash crop, then plantation. This way we will take one by one. So children, last time I have already, in last class I have already explained you the cropping season, which was Rabi, Kharif and Zaid. Seasons, what crops are grown in that season, all that we have done in the previous class. Today children, I will start with a major, one of the major crop. Zaid cropping also I have done in the last class children. And now children, I will start with the next important crop, that is paddy. Paddy means rice children. So children, when you see the paddy crops, when we study about the paddy field or this, children, here you see in the slide, there are many headings, different headings in given in your book. Whereas all combined major points, all the main points from different paragraphs which is given in your book is here shortlisted, and important point is given here. So I will read this, and then again I will read something from your book, and other part you have to read yourself. And children, one thing I want to tell you, while going through the lesson, while reading the lesson, if you find any difficulty, if you have not understand, if you don't understand anything through your video, please, when we meet the next Zoom class or when your comment section, do write your problem so that I can solve your problem. Otherwise, I'll just assume as you have already understood what I have sent through the video. So children, because compact thing I am giving you, it will take lot of time if I go through line by line like we were doing in the class. So children, I have this slide is there, which gives you all the major points regarding the paddy, all about all the major crops. So here the points which are given here is that paddy is the staple food crop in India. See children, at the side temperature and rainfall is also given, which is given in different paragraph in your book. But here we, the major things that you want to know, should know about this crop is that the temperature needed is 22 to 32 degrees, rainfall 150 to between 150 to 300 centimeters. Paddy fields or rice needs lot of water. Now it is the second largest, India is the second largest producer of rice in the world after China. This comes under Kharif crop. Children, I told you that it is the winter crop. This crop grows in the season of Kharif. Now it requires high temperature, that means above 25 degrees, and high humidity. Annual rainfall should be above 100 degrees centimeter. This crop is grown in the plain of north and northeastern India, coastal areas and the deltaic region. I have already mentioned the places where this crop grows. With the help of canal irrigation and tube well growing, paddy has become possible in Punjab, Haryana and western Uttar Pradesh, and part of Rajasthan. Children, why they are saying this? Because paddy needs, this crop needs lot of water. That is why it grows very well at coastal area and deltic area. So that is why in the West Bengal, Assam and Odisha, these places are at the coastal region. They have plentiful supply of water. But now it is possible to grow even in Punjab and Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh and some part of Rajasthan with the help of canal irrigation. So without the help of water or plenty of irrigation, it is not possible to grow this crop. So children, here I am covering rainfall also. I have told you this paddy, about paddy, lot of things I have told you, and rainfall also I have told you. And now children, in this comes two type of rice. The rice crop in India can be grouped into two categories. One is upland rice and lowland. Now, what is upland and lowland rice? Now, children, this type of rice is grown in mountain region. Children, I'll just show, try to find the slide if it is possible, map. I don't know whether map is there or not, but if I find the map, I will show you the map, children, where the distribution of paddy is also shown. Now, children, in this region, I will tell you that paddy field has, this have got two parts of two kinds of rice. Now, children, don't ignore the slide, children. You just listen to me. Okay. Now, children, here the rice, the upland rice is, this type of rice grows in mountainous region. And upland rice is sown in March to April and harvested in September. This type of rice cultivation depend on the distribution of rainfall only. And the entire crop is used locally. Now, children, this map, I was searching this map. Now, we have got the map here. This is the map where distribution of this map is given somewhere in your book, children. Now, I will read the distribution. Children, you come to page number 117. Leave the remaining thing. Method of cultivation, I will read just now. I will explain you method of cultivation and harvesting, practicing. First, come to the distribution. Now, West Bengal. Now, children, rice is the leading crop of West Bengal, occupying about 3/4 of the major crop area. In West Bengal, farmers grow 3 crops a year, which is called mus, and then it is called aman and boro. These are the names which is given in the West Bengal. Then, children, in Uttar Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh has the largest area under rice cultivation. Rice is an important crop in the eastern region of state, 4.5%. Basti, Gorenpur, Deoria, Devaria, Siddharth Nagar, Maharajganj, Gonda and Asangarh are come under 100 leading rice producing district in the country, children. Then comes Andhra Pradesh. Next is Andhra Pradesh, and in this 1/3 of the total occupied area is of the state grows rice. And then although the crop is grown throughout the state, but 5 districts are West Godavari, Krishna, East Godavari and Guntur together contribute more than half of the state rice production. The other rice producing district is Kurnoori, Anantapur, then Vishakhapatnam, Nellore and Chudalganj. These are the places in the Andhra Pradesh region where rice is grown. Then Punjab also grows rice because they have a canal system irrigation. Rice cultivation is the irrigated area of Punjab are introduced in 1970 following the Green Revolution. Here 97% of rice area is irrigated and due to high input of high yielding variety seeds. Now, children, fertilizer mechanization and finance per hectare yield is the highest. Amritsar, Faridkot, Jalandhar and Patiala are the main rice producing area in Punjab. The bulk of the rice grown is exported, but because mostly the people in Punjab, they do not use rice, they mostly use wheat. So the rice is exported. Most of the part of rice is exported. Then comes Tamil Nadu, children. Tamil Nadu is an important producer of rice. Here about 75% of the produce of contributed by Tanjore, South Arcot, then Chundliput, North Arcot and Madurai. This is the place, children, in Tamil Nadu that are known for the grown of rice. So, children, distribution I have told you. In the next class, children, I will tell you the sowing period, then method of cultivation, then method of harvesting. All this I will explain you in the next chapter. So, children, again I want to tell you, go through the chapter And if you find any difficulty in your comment box, you can write, or in Zoom class, we'll discuss and solve your problem. Take care of yourself, children. Have a good day.